네, 안녕하세요, 여러분. 저는 퍼포. 그리고 우리가 퍼포. Alright, that was whatever. My name is Mr. Popo and we are Popo. In this After Effects and Cinema 4D tutorial, we're going to be creating this amazing and stunning and beautifully looking laser effect scan. I'm going to be focusing on the technique rather than the animation. The animation, I'm going to be showing it in the Patreon tutorial. So you can follow me in there and you can support if you would like to learn more about this technique. All right, let's get right into it. So as you can see here, this stunning style frame has a lot of things that we need to discuss. First, we need to learn how to actually bring up this laser detail that we can see. Beautiful, isn't it? This laser detail that happens randomly every frame. Every frame is not going to be exactly the same, and it's going to be just as unique as the real laser effect when it is in a volumetric light. We also have this stunning laser that actually follows whatever this laser lights is coming for, and that's a lot of lasers that I said in a single minute. We also have some beautiful particles that are unfortunately not X particles, or probably fortunately for those who do not own it. We have a lot of beautiful texturing and compositing technique. We have some particular, we have some fog, we have some color correction. That's a lot of things to discuss in this tutorial. So let's start first by discussing the Cinema 4D process of this. Now we are in Cinema 4D. I'm going to be using Redshift. You could use any other standard renderer or any other renderer to do this technique. It applies to literally everything. Nothing is very unique to Redshift, so just apply the same principles into your own renderer. So to start with, I'm gonna start creating the laser, and trying to complicate this even more will just get you nowhere, and you'll just be spending time into trying to figure it out instead of trying to make this even look better. So to do this, what I'm gonna do is, I know that a light is literally a line, so I'm just gonna go and make a cylinder. And if I go and make this super thin, like this, then that's it, that's literally a light. And all I need to do now is, let's just say this is a 700, and then that's it, that's literally a light laser. But it's just one. So if we want more, I'm just gonna clone this. Of course, right now, if we put it here, it's just gonna be a grid, and that's not what I want. For me, I want that cone-like grid. So I'm just gonna go and say, instead of grid, I'm just gonna put it linear. But right now, what is Cinema 4D doing is that it's stacking all these cylinders on top of each other on the y-axis. As you can see here, it's 50. I don't want that. Instead, what I want is, let's say something like this, or maybe 0.6. Okay. I don't have enough counts, so I'm just gonna go and increase this a lot. So here you can have this lightsaber. If this is your thing, please go ahead. But that's not what I'm looking for. So what I'm gonna do instead is, I'm just gonna go and increase this in order to have this sort of light. So I could go and I could even add even more if I wish to. All right. Another thing I like to do, which is way better, is try to randomize this to make it look even more random and way better. So I'm just gonna go select my cloner, go inside here and do a random. So right now I'm gonna have lights all over because the parameter is a little bit too big. That's exactly what you said. So I'm just gonna go and say, I can even turn off the position. I can go to rotation and just say like 0.6. All right, so now they're gonna be a bit different. I could even go here and try to scale this somehow else, you know. Some are gonna be big, some are gonna be small. That's not what she said, but I'm not gonna be using scale for now. I feel like I don't really need it. I only need the rotation, and to me that's better. Now, how are we gonna make this look just like what we did? So first I'm just gonna go, instead of having this look up, I'm just gonna go take this and rotate it for ease of understanding what we're doing. I'm just gonna go push this like that. Perfect. Now we're just gonna look at it as it is. But if we go right away and try to do the shader in here, you'll probably not understand. So I'm gonna assume that you don't know anything about shading. So I'm just gonna go create a plane. I'm gonna put this in. So now we have our material affected on the plane. Now you need to know two things to create this. You need to know that if I want to change the color of something, I can just go and go for a wrap, which is just like in After Effects a wrap, okay? And there are three things that you need to know about the nodes here. Diffuse is how your material is gonna look like. It's like your skin color, okay? So that's the diffuse, it's your skin color. So if I put the diffuse color, this is like the skin color of the plane. And if I try to change the color, I'm gonna be changing the color of my skin, just like in After Effects. This is exactly the same principles in After Effects, okay? So diffuse is your main color. This is your object main color, okay? This is the first thing you need to take care of, okay? The next thing that I wanna show you, I'm just gonna get this back into, let's just do something like that. So we have white, blue, and black. Perfect, it has everything we need to know. If I go and put this into something we called emission, okay? I'm gonna go inside, I'm gonna go overall. You see, this is locked, because now the color of the emission is from the ramp. Now, if I increase the emission, these colors are now gonna put light. So this object is gonna be emissive, it's gonna give out light from the colors that we set already. All right, cool. And then of course we can go overboard. Now, we know what is diffuse, we know what is emission. And then the last thing that I need to show you is opacity. So the brighter color are gonna be visible. This is where I'm gonna see the object. And the black colors, the more contrasty ones, those are gonna hide my object. So for example, if I go and bring in a landscape below my plane, as you can see, I'm seeing through the plane because the black colors, if we take this back into default, you'll see where it is black, I'm not seeing it. See that? It's like I'm hiding, I'm fading, I'm masking my object just by controlling this color. Okay, that's all you need to create a laser, okay? Now, what I'm gonna show you is how to get these cutty kind of laser looking instead of having just one cylinder. So to do that, I'm gonna combine two things. I'm gonna combine a ramp, and then I'm gonna combine our favorite effector, at least it's mine and probably Andrew Kramer too. It's noise. This is your fractal noise. So let's put this into the diffuse. This is what I have. This is literally just like your normal fractal noise. And if you go, you could clamp the brightness here and the contrast of how you want this to look. Okay, so this is where you control the black and white of your fractal noise. And then inside here, basically you have the type of noise just like inside of After Effects, okay? You can increase the complexity, the number of details. You can do a lot of things when it comes to this. So let's just add a little bit of distortion, for example. We can even try to distort it as much as we want, like that. We can even go below the bar and go even small, okay? And here is where you can actually just scale up or down your noise. You can even go here, and it's gonna be even smaller. If you wanna stretch it, you can just go like zero. And then you'll just have this. And if this is what you're looking for in terms of laser, you can actually just use this plane as a laser now. Okay, so this is a setup scene example, very quick and dirty, of how to use this noise texture that we just created. So here I have a plane that is using a spline to warp like this. So now what I could do is if I move this, if I move the spline instead, this laser can actually keep on going. And you have to know that by using a displacer and using the same technique, putting 0, 0, 0 and just having the Y or the Z value moving, I'm gonna have this kind of movement of light. So you can keep this in mind that you could use this technique this way. And it was actually used on the same project that I was inspired to do this tutorial from. Now you literally have everything you need to know about creating a laser. The only thing that I need to do now is color it. So I'm just gonna go take my this ramp and put it as an emission color. And all I need to do now is try to color it to, I don't know. No, this is in diffuse. Okay, that's why. I'm just gonna turn this off and I'm gonna put this in opacity instead of diffuse. So we only see the bright part, and I could just put this in here. I could even change this to have a colorful light if that's what I wish to do. So I have a lot of control here. I can make my own, or I can just pick whatever, just like here. Okay, so I'm just gonna go back to sky. Another thing you need to know is you can change this from horizontal to vertical. You can even have a radial circular thing if that's what you wish for. All right, so this could be your laser if that's what you wish for. I'm gonna go back to my light, and I'm gonna put this in here. Okay, it's vertical. Cool. Now all we need is a texture noise, and I'm gonna put it in here. Overall opacity. I'm gonna go and try to clamp this. Go into noise. I'll probably just add some distortions into this one. I'll probably go to 111. I can even make this even more complicated and go 1010. Perfect. When it comes to random, I can just try to randomize this a little bit more. I don't like actually this, so I'm just gonna go and do a sky. Perfect. I'm gonna go to the clamping. I'll try to clamp this as much as I could. So when I try and go into my light, I'm gonna have something that is way better than what was before. So I'm just gonna go here, and I can go to the emission and add like 5 if I want to. This is actually done. Again, as I said, you could animate this by going into noise coordinate, and you can just try to play with the offset. So I'm just gonna go put a color here, then go another keyframe and just move this, put a keyframe. Cool. So what's gonna happen now is that this is animated now. So if I go inside here, random, and try to randomize this a bit. So this is the kind of very laser light effect. Now, we figured out the effect of doing this inside a shader and doing the light effect. Now, how do we do that laser, this one? How do we do this laser that is on the tree, for example? So instead of the tree, because it's really high poly, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna create an area light. Okay, that is one. So I have an area light. And then what I want, so I'm just gonna go like this. I'm gonna create, we can just create actually a cube. Perfection. Now, here's the thing about this. Is that if I try to do a line, it's not really giving me a line. And that is because I need to go inside my general. And when it comes to spread, I'll just put it down to 0.01. That's it. That's all I need to do. So all I have to do now is put this like that. Okay. And I'm just gonna line it to my laser like so. I'm just gonna put it in the center. And now I'll put this cloner on the area light. So what that means is that if I control, I'll take this off. So if I control my area light, my laser thing, I'm actually controlling also the lasers, and it's scanning. All right. That's it for this first part of creating the laser effect. If you want to check on how I went into the scene and I created the particles and I created all this scan and made the laser cut really crispy and as details as you can see on the cell frames on the reference video, you can actually check the Patreon where I put a project file. I also explain more about the process of creating all these subtle details that I added to the style frame. When it comes to compositing, that's what's gonna happen next and on the last part of this tutorial. I hope you enjoyed this one. Don't forget to put a like and hit that subscribe button to see more of motion graphics tutorial that probably do not exist anywhere else but here. My name is Mr. Popo, and we are Popo. I'll see you on the next one.